Hello everyone, welcome back to Visualverse. I'm your host Arun Prakash. Today we are diving into a crucial aspect of video production that can make or break your footage. Bit tip. Ever wonder why your videos don't quite look like those Hollywood blockbusters? Bit depth might be one of the key reasons. Let's unravel this mystery together. Bit depth is a fundamental concept in digital imaging that impacts everything from color accuracy to the robustness of your footages during color grading. But what exactly is bit depth? At its core, bit depth refers to the number of bits used to store color information for each pixel in an image. This determines how many shades of each color can be represented. Let's break it down. In an 8-bit video, each color channel, red, green, and blue, can have 256 possible shades. This gives us a total of approximately 16.7 million possible colors. While this seems like a lot, it's quite limited compared to the higher bit depths. In contrast, a 10-bit video supports 1024 possible shades per color channel, resulting in over 1 billion possible colors. That's a significant increase. So why does bit depth matter for your videos? The higher the bit depth, the more color information your camera captures. This becomes particularly important during post-production. In an 8-bit video, you might encounter issues like banding or color artifacts when you make substantial adjustments. This is due to the limited color information available to smooth out transitions. With 10-bit video, those issues are minimized. The extra color information allows for smoother gradient and more nuanced adjustments. Most consumers and beginners cameras like DSLRs and mirrorless cameras may record 8-bit internally. While this is sufficient for everyday shooting, the limitations become evident during intensive color grading. High-end cinema cameras, however, often record in 10-bit or even 12-bit RAW format. This additional bit depth allows for greater flexibility and higher quality results in post-production. Bit depth doesn't just affect color grading, it impacts the entire workflow. The 10-bit files are larger and require more processing power to edit. This means more storage space and a powerful computer. However, the trade-off is worth it if you're aiming for the highest quality footage. To fully grasp bit depth, we need to understand how it interacts with color spaces and gamma curves. Color spaces define how much of the full spectrum of color and luminance values can be captured and displayed. Common color spaces like Rec. 709 have a relatively narrow gamut, which limits the range of colors and luminance values. High-end cameras often use wider color spaces, such as C-Log, S-Log, which can capture more colors than most devices can display. This extensive color range provides more options for color grading. Gamma curves, on the other hand, determines how color and luminance information is stored. Non-linear gamma curves, like those in log profiles, preserve more details in shadows and highlights, enhancing the dynamic range. Dynamic range measures the ratio between the darkest and brightest part of an image. Higher dynamic range means more detail in both shadows and highlights. While human eyes can perceive up to 20 stops of dynamic range, cameras are limited. For instance, the beginner mirrorless cameras can capture only 10 or 11 stops, whereas Red Weapon can capture up to 16.5 stops. This limitation is why footage from cameras doesn't look as good as what we see with our own eyes. Cameras simply can't capture the same level of the details across the entire luminance range. Bit depth also affects practical aspects like artifacting and color banding. Artifacts occurs when there isn't enough data to represent complex scenes accurately, leading to visible errors. Color banding, on the other hand, happens when there isn't enough shades to create smooth gradient, resulting in noticeable band of colors. This is why higher bit depths are crucial for achieving professional quality footage. Digital video stores information as separate luma and chroma components. This separation allows for compression, reducing the amount of data needed. Color sampling ratios like 444, 422, and 420 represent the different levels of chroma compression. 444 is uncompressed and 422 compressed chroma by half horizontally, and 422 compresses both horizontal and vertically. Most DSLRs shoot in 420, which significantly reduces the color information. This compression, combined with lower bit depths, limits the quality and flexibility of your footage. If you're working with an 8-bit camera, there are still ways to improve your footage. First, aim to get the best possible image in camera. Accurate exposure and white balances are crucial. Second, consider using an external recorder that supports higher bit depths. This can significantly enhance your footage quality. Finally, invest in camera that offers higher bit depths if your budget allows. Options like Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera provide advanced features and better bit depths at an affordable price. So, what does this all mean for us as a videographer? Understanding bit depth and its impact on your footage can dramatically improve your video quality. While Hollywood-level production may seem out of reach, using the right tool and technique can get you much closer. Remember, capturing the best possible image in camera and leveraging the higher bit depths will give you the more flexibility in post-production and better overall result. Thanks for joining me on this video. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future content. Drop your questions and comments below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Happy filming, and thank you.